Sundogs, the incredible weather phenomena explained. Can you make this image stay still? This is one of the most viral optical illusions. You can find it literally everywhere on the internet. These are known as physiological illusions because they are caused by the overstimulation of the brain senses. Basically, your brain is seeing too much color and light here. There's no way it can process all of the information. This optical illusion is an artificial one made by humans just like you. But everybody knows nature itself likes to trick us with its own made optical illusions. For instance, check this out. This underwater waterfall along the shoreline of Mauritius is not what it seems. And while the sky may look like ocean waves, this is actually a special kind of cloud. In this video, we are going to talk about a particular optical illusion that is created in some particular circumstances. Sundogs. The ingredients? Sunlight, ice crystals, and air. The result is incredible. Keep watching to get to know more about these fantastic phenomena and how to spot it. What sundogs really are. So have you ever seen two suns in the sky? It would be crazy, wouldn't it? And yet some people claim they have seen two of them. Do you think they're going crazy? No, they're actually fine. It's just what's known as a sundog. Sundogs are the illusions of two additional suns visible in the sky. They're caused by ice crystals in the atmosphere, which refract sunlight and create these bright patches of light. They often appear alongside a halo around the sun, and they especially like cold winter weather. Sundogs usually occur in pairs, and they can seem like color spots or look so intense that it's like you're seeing two suns. The recipe. You have to be very lucky to see a sundog. First of all, you will need an atmosphere. You probably won't be able to spot sundogs on Mercury, for instance, because Mercury has a very thin one. And then you'll need crystals, but not the expensive ones, ice crystals. More specifically, you'll need hexagonal plate crystals of ice suspended in clouds. On Earth, these are usually located around 20,000 feet and higher up to 40,000 feet. Just as a comparison, the common cruising altitude for most commercial airplanes is between 33,000 and 42,000 feet. It's not uncommon to find ice crystals at this height. Actually, the next time you fly, check the ice crystals forming on the plane window. They look like snowflakes on a blue background. But these particular hexagonal ice crystals you need to see sundogs are not only found in the sky. You might find them much closer to the ground, in extremely cold climates, where temperatures drop below 22 degrees Fahrenheit, as a meteorological phenomenon called diamond dust. The diamond dust can cause a cloudless sky to snow, unlike ordinary snow. This is possible thanks to another weather phenomenon called temperature inversion. Normally, air temperatures get colder as you travel from ground level up to higher altitudes, but with inversion, this is flipped. Cold air sits near the surface with warmer air above it. Inversion happens when air near the ground is trapped by a layer of warm air. This layer of warm air acts like a lid and stops the air from rising and cooling. This results in air temperature increasing with altitude instead of decreasing, the opposite of what normally happens. Since the air isn't rising and cooling, it can evaporate any of the moisture in the air, so the air becomes more humid. The cold air at ground level eventually chills the humid air, and its moisture condenses, forming ice crystals. This combination of cold temperatures, moisture, and lack of movement is what causes diamond dust to form. It typically happens in areas with very low temperatures and no wind, so the layer of warm air can remain in place and trap the cold air below it. When the sun is out, it warms the layer of warm air, the ice crystals sparkle and appear like tiny stars in the sky, hence the name diamond dust. So why do we need hexagonal plate crystals in order for a sundog to appear? Well, these ice crystals are shaped like six-sided plates. Each plate has two flat sides that are faces and four sides that are edges. The sunlight enters through one of the faces and then exits through another face that is inclined 60 degrees from the first. When this happens, the light is bent or refracted so that it deviates from the sun. This deviation is called an optical refraction, and it causes the light to form a halo around the sun that is 22 degrees away. When this light is concentrated in bright spots next to the sun, it forms sundogs. Sundogs may also have long curved tails of light that come from the vertical edges of the flat hexagonal ice crystals. These tails are created by the reflection of light from the edges of the ice crystals. So to see a sundog in the sky, we need cold weather, but that's not enough. We need these special hexagonal plate ice crystals in the air. Without the hexagonal crystals, we wouldn't be able to see the bright sundogs next to the sun. Moreover, we won't see any sundog if the sky was completely covered with clouds. Have you ever seen one? Or are you just like me hoping to catch one? Let us know in the comments below. The name. I know what you're thinking. What do dogs have to do with the sun and optical illusions? Allow me to explain. In the Greek mythology, there's the figure of Zeus. Zeus is the chief deity, the most important god of all. He was a sky and weather god, sender of thunder and lightning, rain and winds. He was called the father of both gods and men. He had a lot of children, and he was actually known for his amorousness, and he had a bunch of love affairs with both mortal and immortal women. Not only did he have children, though, Greeks were convinced he also owned dogs. It was believed the god Zeus walked his dogs across the sky, and that the bright false suns in the sky on either side of the sun's disk were the dogs. Doesn't it make much more sense to you now? Hey, if you're enjoying the video, why don't you subscribe to the channel? It means a lot to us. Anyway, let's try to get the most out of sundogs. The crystals refract sunlight in a way that causes the edges of sundogs closer to the sun to be a reddish hue, while the outer edges take on a blue color and the middles of the features are yellow or orange. Have you ever heard of a prism? It is a fantastic tool we have to split white light in its colored components. A prism works because the different colors of light travel at different speeds inside the glass. Because the colors of light travel at different speeds, they get bent by different amounts and come out all spread out instead of mixed up. Violet travels the slowest, so it is on the bottom, and red travels the fastest, so it is on the top. This is because of what is called the index of refraction. The higher index of refraction means that the violet light is the most bent, and red is then the least bent because of its lower index of refraction, and the other colors fall somewhere in between. As for sundogs, the color variation is caused by the index of refraction when sunlight passes through the ice crystals. Just as the white light hitting on a prism, sunlight is composed of a white light with different frequencies, and low-frequency light of longer wavelengths, such as red, is refracted less than high-frequency light of shorter wavelengths, like blue. This causes red light to remain closer to the sun, while blue light is dispersed further out, much like what happens in a rainbow. Sundogs can also have a range of shapes and sizes, depending on the size of the ice crystals which cause them. Larger crystals cause sundogs to be taller. Overall, sundogs are a beautiful and awe-inspiring sight in the sky, a reminder of the intricate physics of the natural world. Sundogs around the moon. A few people here and there have also seen sundogs and halos appear around the moon. And if you ever had any doubts, don't worry. It's a completely natural phenomenon and does not present any danger to us humans. Just like a sundog, a moondog or mock moon is a bright spot you can see near the moon in the sky. It looks like two faint patches of light that appear 22 degrees to the left and right of the moon. In the case of the moon, moondogs are caused by moonlight reflecting off of ice crystals in the high clouds. They are rarer than sundogs because the moon needs to be very bright, like a quarter moon or more, for you to be able to see them, and this happens few times along one moon's orbit. Moreover, moondogs show little color to the unaided human eye because their light is not bright enough to activate the eye's cone cells, and therefore are harder to spot. Sundogs and moondogs are fascinating phenomena happening when it's cold outside. During winter, people enjoy staying inside, perhaps chilling, watching Netflix, and drinking a good hot chocolate. But who knows? Maybe among you guys, there's some adventurer ready to become a sundog hunter. What type of person are you? Let us know in the comments below. And remember, the next time you're out on a chilly winter day, don't be surprised if you spot two suns in the sky. Instead, be grateful for the unique and remarkable light show that nature is giving you. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. What do you think about sun dogs and moon dogs? Leave us a comment and don't forget to like the video. See you soon.